So, summarizing the sensitivity analysis of the effects of varying the parameters on system number two, the summary becomes that 10% increase in interest rate will result in 6.14% increase in the power generation cost. Similarly, 10% increase in depreciation period will decrease 1.37% decrease in the power generation cost. 10% increase in overall investment will increase in will basically increase 8.9% increase in power generation cost. Similarly, 10% increase in operation of the yearly cost will increase 2.05% of the power generation cost. So these are the analysis, and also the 10% increase in the full load hours will basically decrease the 8.22% of the generation cost. So, concluding, we can say that 10% increase in full load hours will result in highest decrease in power generation, and it will stand at 8.22%. 10% increase in overall investment will result in highest increase in power generation cost at 8.9%, and 10% increase in interest rate will result in 6.14% increase in power generation cost. And 10% increase in operation cost and depreciation period will result in minor variation of power generation cost at 2.05% and 1.37% respectively. So, how to decrease the cost? Investment and full load hours are most significantly in significant factors in influencing the electricity generation cost, and 10% increase in investment will lead to 8.9% increase in electricity cost, while 10% increase in full load hours will lead to 8.22% decrease in electricity cost. Operation cost and the payback period only have a slight impact on the power generation cost, and interest rates moderately affect the cost of electricity. So now coming to the environmental analysis, let us first discuss about the construction environment. When buildings during normal operation, in case when an accident and the end of the operation of hydroelectric power station. Now we will discuss their environmental effects. So first of all, hydroelectric power stations are similar to wind power stations, partially products of the traditional mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. Therefore, for example, during the production of turbines or generators, all kind of environmental effects are on soil, water, and air typically. For these sectors, special precautionary measures should be taken, however, because of the current far-reaching environmental regulations, the corresponding environmental effects are generally kept at a comparatively low level construction. Hydroelectric power stations are similar to wind power stations. The difference is that the generating medium in hydroelectric, we use water energy and kinetic energy associated with the movement of water, and in wind power, we use the wind. Kinetic energy that is associated to the movement of wind. So therefore, for example, during the production of turbines and generators, all kind of environmental effects for water and air are approximately the same. the material like generators are the same. The potential for the accidental damage during the production process with some specific exceptions for like steel smelting, but the cases of steel smelting in built dams and generators is relatively low as compared to the other hazards. So smelting is a form of extractive metallurgy. It is used to extract many metals from their ore, which include silver, iron, copper and other base metals. So exposure to airborne pollutants from the metal processing and the smelting can lead to various acute and chronic diseases. Initial and sudden exposure can lead to an irritation of eyes, nose and throat, and in most serious conditions and can be chronic effects at heart, and might develop lungs problem as well, and even premature deaths in certain cases. Additionally, there are environmental effects linked to the construction of hydroelectric power stations and hydroelectric power stations with their reservoirs in particular. At the plant location, we can say that water pollution is caused by the construction material or fine soil getting into the stream, release of fine particles caused by excavation and improper cleaning of the building machinery. And on the second point, we can say that the oil losses due to the improper handling during the construction and maintenance work that might also contribute to the water pollution. Similarly, oil seepage and it is commonly common from hydraulic systems during the demolition works, for example. So these might contribute in the water pollution. So these environmental pollutants can be, however, avoided or at least minimized by introducing an appropriate operational procedures and observing the existing safety and environmental regulations that are being imposed by the government. Additionally, there is a corresponding accidental potential also with supra-regional environmental effects, especially when the building hydraulic power stations with large dams and reservoirs or large run of river power stations, for example, in case of flooding. However, it is appropriate if the regulations are observed and no significant environment effects have to be expected.